Welcome friends, today we are in conversation with Dr. Patrick Lungu. He is head of the Tuberculosis and Leprosy Program in Zambia. And Dr. Patrick Lungu and I both are here at the TB-HIV Symposium, which is being held right before the 10th IES Conference on HIV Science in Mexico. Dr. Patrick Lungu, please share your insights on the latent tuberculosis and other issues which we just discussed back in the symposium room.
Yeah, thank you very much. I'm happy to be here at the TB-HIV Symposium here in Mexico. I'm happy to share my perspective of latent TB with the HIV colleagues. I think to begin with, I want to share with you that TB is the number one infectious killer in the world. TB kills one in every three people living with HIV. That's how big the burden of TB is. Today we are happy and proud to have one of our key interventions, which is TB preventive therapy. TB preventive therapy gives a protection of about 60 to 90% against TB. If we're going to end TB in this world, TB preventive therapy is our biggest armory that we have today. As I earlier shared with you, that TB preventive therapy gives protection against TB of about 60 to 90%. I think so far there has never been any intervention that gives us such high level protection against TB. If we're going to bend the curve, and if we are going to end TB come 2030, we have to implement TB preventive therapy to a large scale and with speed. I want us to remember two S's of importance. The first S is scale, the second S is speed. So if we are going to end this TB epidemic that is killing a good number of our citizenry, a good number of our people, and here we're talking about people living with HIV, we need to scale up TB preventive therapy to a large scale. Every patient at risk of developing TB should be on TB preventive therapy, because providing TB preventive therapy is an ethical issue. We need to give what benefits our patient, and also we have to prevent any harm that can affect our people. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Patrick. Can you also share us your insights on how to accelerate progress towards ending tuberculosis in Zambia and globally?
Yeah, so I think to accelerate ending TB, both in Zambia and globally, is that we have to engage a lot of mouth stakeholders. This is one step that we should not fear to do. We should not fear to engage on the questions that arise with regard to approach to TB preventive therapy. It's one of the key steps that needs to be undertaken. We have to address all the questions that are there. The beauty is that we have all the information with regard to how TB preventive therapy works. So in terms of acceleration, the first step is that we have to do mouth stakeholder engagement. I also just want to share with you that the larger work has been done so far. The first steps have also been done, and the first steps here we're talking about developing policy documents, developing guidelines. And I think we are happy that WHO has provided the greatest resource, and here we're talking about the latest Latin TB guidelines that we have. And I think one of the things that about what is good about these resource documents is that they're very comprehensive and driven by the existing evidence. So the second step follows is to create demand. And here we need to make every person at risk be wary of this preventive therapy that is available, a therapy that is going to prevent loss of lives. So the second step, which is also quite critical, is that we need to make people aware of the burden of TB. We need to make people aware of the risk and also the means to prevent TB. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Patrick. Thank you.